It's the plotline in Line of Duty. Spoiler alert, I'm afraid we're about to discuss the hit police drama. So if you aren't up to date...
Yeah, leave the room. Line of Duty has the nation hooked on attempting to solve who the mysterious H is, the person supposedly leading the deadly organised crime group.
We're hoping all is revealed on this Sunday's finale, but as we speculate and wait for answers, we thought we'd ask three of Britain's brightest crime-solving brains, just who is H? Peter, two H's locked together, housing, of course, the women who've unfortunately been trafficked.
Yes, indeed. So, I mean, the possibilities are endless, aren't they? And I'm hoping that we are going to get some answers on Sunday evening, but I'm sure with Mr. Mercurio's quite brilliant writing that there will be lots of threads and questions unanswered, which will then propel us into the next series.
So do you think we'll get to finally know who H is, whether it's the building that you believe it is, a sort of a mysterious headquarters, or whether...
It's an individual.
I'm as confused as everybody else.
Why am I here?
I quite frankly don't know, but I'm loving it, absolutely loving it. Although I do have grave concerns for Ted. I think Ted Hastings is going to get wrongly convicted. People will suspect that he's corrupt.
It's got to be someone, obviously, who's got access to AC-12's intelligence. So you and I are of the theory that it's a case of Cherchez la femme, and she's been fodder for Hastings for quite some time now.
Jill Bigelow, of course, the legal counsel.
Melindy mentioned that before. So, Polly Walker is fantastic as the vixen of the piece.
For the head of the anti-corruption, he seems extraordinarily naive about some of these things, Peter, which gets a little bit frustrating. Taking that money... I mean, he wants to believe that the guy that's giving him the money is actually going to help him get out of his financial woes. But, seriously, I mean, to have 50 grand in an envelope sitting in your hotel room when he's staying at, sort of, you know, a Premier Inn, it looks very suspicious.
He thought it was documents, though, didn't he, until he opened it?
But either way, that whole thing... I mean,
you've been there in a hotel room with a load of used notes.
Peter, does it
on
bear...
On many an occasion.
Not necessarily your own.
Undercover.
Yeah.
Well, that's it. I mean, do you think it bears any relation to real-life policing and detective work and corruption, for that matter?
Once upon a time, I knew of some corrupt detectives who stole £200,000, divided it amongst themselves, and then one detective shared it with somebody who wasn't corrupt, who he was having a relationship with. OK? Are you following the thread?
Yeah.
Right.
More so than Line of Duty, to be honest.
When the corrupt gang found out that one of the previously straight detectives had received some of the money, they went, oh, no, this is a weak link. And a detective got hold of me and he said, they're going to kill her. What are we going to do?
No.
Suffice to say, I'm not going to say exactly what I did, but that detective is still alive today. That murder didn't happen. But, yeah, so, you know, does,
that escalated. Line, of duty,
does Line of Duty reflect the truth? In some regards, but it's a drama, so you've just got to sit back, have a glass of something a little stronger than that, and thoroughly enjoy it.
My God, have you just given away the plot for the next scene?
Jake Mercurio is frantically scrabbling this down.
Hang on!
He'll join us on Plus One to complete his notes, right?
But undoubtedly, there's positions. We see it all the time. Andy McNab famously has become a consultant on a lot of these situations. Well, they'll get former murder squad detectives or anti-corruption vice detectives in to consult on these things for that reason.
Yeah, absolutely. And I've done drama consultancy. It's part of what I do. And of course, but you mustn't let the reality get in the way of the storytelling.
No.
So you can't sit there with writers and producers and execs and say, no, it's not like that. This is how it happens. Just, you know,
let the drama go.
Just very quickly then, before we crash on, we've asked you to get in touch, obviously, this morning with your theories. Someone's actually said, what about Mrs. Hastings?
Yes.
Could that be the reason she was attacked? And Hastings' on-off girlfriend Jill is also in the fray as well, according to you guys on Twitter, etc.
Mike agrees with Peter. H is for headquarters. H is the building.
You've got a theory of the final shot. Should we put it out?
No, Jamie East was in earlier, and he thinks what will happen is that Hastings is going to get sent down, and then just as it's closing, the computer screen that they communicate with is just going to come and flick into life, and then some words are going to get written on the screen, and we're going to be left with the idea that H is still communicating and the wrong person's been sent down.
H is still at large.
Yeah, and Hastings has been banged up.
So let's see if Ben Shepherd really does know anything about the world.
Just nick that off Jamie East. Don't worry about that.